Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Azima, back with another video, as you guys know. So in my last video I was talking about the release dates and everything you guys have to know about the new phone that is coming out very soon, which is the S series of the Samsung Galaxy phones that is coming. That is on the 14th of January. What happened? So I talked about the launch date, I talked about everything you guys need to know, the specs, I think, and stylist, everything that is coming out. So I want you guys to stay subscribed to my channel because we are going to be doing the live video on my own channel too. And tomorrow there will be a live Exynos chipset on my channel. So please stay subscribed to my channel to enjoy all this offers. So today we are going to be talking about technology. I want me and you to talk. I want us to interact. My 48 subscribers, I want us to talk about technology. So now we all know that there are many things that phones have gone into. Before, we know that most phones that started with, they had landlines. So all these landlines were like boxy phone which we all put in our ears that last just for 30 minutes and was so big in our eardrums that I can't believe me having that type of phone and actually surviving any life now, because internet, social media platform has taken everywhere. Entertainment is now on another level. But now we want to talk about some future things that we are expecting, like in this near future, that will be in our smartphones. We know many things have already gone. We have bezel-less displays now. We have fingerprint scanner inbuilt in the display. We have inbuilt camera phones. Fine, we have one prototype. We have different things that have gone through our phones. You cannot tell me that the way your landline, your Nokia Touch series, aka Tonos Survey, how it looks, is the way your phone looks now. We have a lot of curved displays. We have a lot of technology that has gone through most smart mobile phones which we are all using. So we are going to talk about the first one, which is foldables. So Samsung now is merging both the Note series and the S series together, because if you hear they are reviewed, I'm very sure that there's a Note, there's a stylist that's coming with their S series this year. So I think that this collaboration of the Note series and the S series will make it possible for them to push this their foldable phones out to you guys, for you guys to buy, and that is what they believe that the future of the phone should be. So we have different phones like the Z Flip, which they have made. We also have phones like the Galaxy Fold 1 and the Galaxy Fold 2. With the Galaxy Fold 2, are most YouTubers' favorites, as I made in one of my videos. So these phones are very innovative, and we thank God for the OLED display, sorry, that's in it, that makes this flexible screen be able to fold into any orientation which it is in. So the future of phone is going to be, for the next series, it's going to be foldables. Even as some articles said, I had HTC is coming back, and HTC will be coming back with foldable phones. So most devices, most companies are going to be pushing out their foldables, and Apple too, they are coming out with a foldable phone. Huawei always have their own foldables, I guess. Is it Huawei or Oppo? I don't know. But I know it's Huawei or something that they made a foldable phone. Even Samsung has a lot of foldable devices. So I think the nearest future to us is going to be everyone who has a foldable phone, something that is pocketable. Well, me, I don't really have any interest in all, but I really like the one that is called the Z Flip, which is easier for me to like have a normal phone screen and close it to a post form factor. That is the way me, I like my phone. I don't like it too big or something, but if I get my hand on the Z Flip, I'm going to appreciate it. The second one is that wireless devices. So your phone will not have any port, will not have any place to plug any wires. Everything will be done wirelessly. So that is what Apple is trying to achieve by putting MagSafe in the box, by putting MagSafe at the back of their phone so that it's charged wirelessly. Well, that is not actually wireless, because you still have a cable. I know technology will get to a point that you just walk into your own and boom, your phone is already charging. But for this nearest future, we are seeing that smartphones will just charge wirelessly when you drop them on a particular part because of this electromagnetic waves that is going through in and out of the phones. So Apple has already removed ditched the headphone jacks of phone, which many people are doing. They have started removing charger from the phones so that people can go wireless. So everything you'll be doing will be wireless. Even now, everybody is patronizing different Bluetooth headsets, like the one on my ear. You see Bluetooth watches, and everything is done wirelessly. You control your smartphone wirelessly. Everything should be done wirelessly now. So for the next feature that is coming, everything will be done wirelessly. So try as much as possible to get that into your mind and get prepared for 2022, 2023 and 2025 innovations that are coming very soon. The third one which we have on our list is on-screen cameras. Fine, I've said that one. Many phones are, we have one prototype of the on-screen display, which the under-camera display, which is really nice, and it will make it easier for you to have a full screen to yourself, so you can enjoy a movie, watch different things, have the capacity to do every goddamn thing with your phone, and you will enjoy it. So you will see that you can watch a full movie on your phone and the screen will be quite wild and better for you to use. So if the camera is shifted to the back of the display, it will be really nice, because find the way the prototype that work, it will make the pixel at where the camera is, it will turn that off, and it will, like, I don't know how the technology works, but it will be able to see through the pixels and take the picture, and it will have some software capability to be able to turn the image from any pixel that is making it too, either too cool or too warm. It will make it possible for it to bring out a normal picture, which is really nice, and you will see. But in the next feature, you see phones that will have under screen camera that will take even better pictures than the one we saw now. So I would love it if the camera will be at the middle of the phone. You know, most of us, when we are vlogging, it's difficult for us to look at the camera. We all like looking at the screen where your face is. So if the camera was around this place, maybe the middle of the phone, it would be easier for you to, like, look at the camera. It would be as if you are communicating with the other people that are watching you, and it would be much, much better. So also the fourth one is voice and gesture control. We already have that. We have Google Assistant, we have Bixby, we have Alexa, we have Cortana for laptop, we have different assistant in phones. So what I think is that this will get much, much better. Instead of you talking in a robot way to your assistant, it will be very, very, very easier to talk to it, to a level that it will be as if you're talking to a normal human being, and the conversation between you and your assistant will be very, very, very better. It will have a good flow with you and your assistant. You feel the touch as if they have emotions like you. So in the nearest future, we'll have gesture control. Fine, we have some. Fine, they are not perfect, but we still see in notes with your expert, if you swerve up, maybe take a selfie, twist your pen to rewind a YouTube video or something like that. In the nearest future, you see that perfected, and it will be really nice. You have everything done by your phone, even without you talking to it or telling it anything, and it's going to greet you and talk to you. We have different samples, but it will be very, very much better in the few years that is coming. And the last one on the list is 5G. So we all know that 5G is not yet strong. It's only in some particular countries that we have it, and it's not possible for 5G to stay outside your door, because anything that blocks the wave will actually stop that 5G, and it will go down to either 4G or 3G. We have different samples from MKBHD and stuff. Even you go behind the house, the signal is already cut off. So I know that 5G is not yet strong. There are different phones, T-Mobile, Nokia, even some other companies. Fine, Huawei is not there due to their own problems. But many companies are trying to invest in this 5G so that within a second or twinkling of an eye, you will see how fast your video download. You'll be able to stream 4K, 8K videos online. That is really nice. So 5G is not yet on. You know, mobile phones that even use 5G, they overheat. They'll do this. So in this next future, all these things should be very, very well, and it will be corrected that maybe all houses will have a 5G tower. Maybe they have to install a 5G tower in every houses for it to work because of the type of wave you use. So these are the five things which I know that in the nearest future, in 3, 4, 5 years, will be included in different phones. So guys, stay subscribed to this channel. If you have anything that you want to talk to me about or you want to let me know about my channel, drop that in the comment section below. If you are subscribed, thank you very much. I love you guys and peace.